Hey, what's up guys, it's Ronaldo here. So this video is going to focus on multi-choice's decision to completely disassociate themselves with Steve Hofmeyr. Now, yeah, it's going to be a weird video to make because anybody that knows me knows that I'm not a fan of Steve Hofmeyr. There are many reasons for that. I'm blocked by him on social media. So that should tell you the kind of relationship that we have, or rather the lack of a relationship. And I'm completely fine with that. With that being said, however, I have to make this video on a principled stance because what MultiChoice has done is completely unacceptable. Now, first and foremost, I completely understand and respect that a private company can associate with whomever they want to, and if they don't want to associate with somebody like Steve Hofmeyr, then it's their right to do so. However, there's a little bit of a problem here. MultiChoice's reason for not wanting to be associated with Steve Hofmeyr is really in a massive contradiction with them supporting people like Julius Malema and Andile Mngatama. Now, why am I associating a musician with a politician, you might ask? Well, why not? You expect more from a politician. You expect a politician to be more principled and more honest about what is going on and to avoid being a racist, a sexist, hateful or hurtful. But clearly, that's not the case in South Africa. So here we've got MultiChoice that has now distanced himself from Steve Hofmeyr and do not want to associate themselves with anything that he does. But they will gladly fund galas for the EFF and allow Julius Malema to sing songs like Kill the Boer, to make statements like that he's going to slit the throat of whiteness, and then also providing a platform for the BLF and Andile Mngatama, which sings One Settler, One Bullet, and also a white person can't join his organization. So MultiChoice is fine with allowing those individuals on their platform, but somebody like Steve Hofmeyr, clearly not. It's also important to note that MultiChoice is very selective in when they're applying this principled stance of theirs all of a sudden. Because if you look at what Steve Hofmeyr has said over his lifetime, and you compare it to what somebody like Julius Malema and Andile Mngatama has said, then there really is no comparison between the two. I haven't seen Steve Hofmeyr asking for the slaughtering of a specific ethnicity. I haven't seen Steve Hofmeyr asking that a person gets killed because of the color of their skin. And listen, like I've said before, I am not a fan of Steve Hofmeyr. I think that Steve Hofmeyr is an opportunist. But yet, if we have to be honest with one another and compare the two, there simply is no comparison. So to end off this video, it's quite unfortunate that MultiChoice has suddenly decided to take this principled stance, but yet MultiChoice itself will gladly associate and even support and finance galas in which political organizations are calling for the slaughtering of people because of the color of their skin. That shows the current dynamic that's at play in South Africa. Have we reached that point in South Africa where private companies like MultiChoice are willing to sacrifice the principle for the relationship? Because to me it seems that way. We've got companies that are willing to just go where the buying power is currently. And you can't tell me that you haven't seen that trend. If you look at the type of advertisements that are coming out that are so anti-white these days, I mean, you can clearly see who these companies are targeting. It's quite sad to see how MultiChoice have completely disintegrated with regards to their value system. Because what MultiChoice has done here is to show what absolute hypocrites they are. They are willing to sacrifice one individual based on what he has said, but they're not willing to apply the same responsibilities and accountabilities of other people. And you have to ask your question, why? Do they treat those people with special gloves because of specific reasons or just because they care about profits? And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoy my content, then please consider supporting me on Patreon. The link is in the description below. Also, please be sure to drop a comment and let me know what you think about this incident. Also, please be sure to smash that like button. Let's see if we can get 1,650 likes on this video. Also, please be sure to subscribe, and if you are subscribed, hit that bell icon so that you can be notified of my future uploads. Lastly, and most importantly, please be sure to share this video with your friends and family because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.